Hello everyone, I'm Andrew Can, and if I can, so can you. In this video, we're going to be talking about changes to the YouTube platform.
Here it is, the new YouTube Studio beta. At a first glance, let me know in the comments below, what do you think of the YouTube Studio redesign? I think it looks really good and makes a lot of sense with the new YouTube material design they're currently working on. I think that the one channel design looks good, but I understand it's 4 years old at the time of this video, and I'm really enjoying the redesign. However, before we get to the Creator Studio beta, it's important to note that some channels won't have access to this, and you can check the link in the description below to check if you have access. If you do have access, on your YouTube dashboard you will see the new Creator Studio, like shown here. It's also important to note about the beta that YouTube says, we're building it to be more intuitive to use than the current Creator Studio, now called Creator Studio Classic. At first, you'll see fewer features than you're used to, so you'll likely still have to use Creator Studio Classic. You'll see more features added to the YouTube Studio beta over the coming months. That said, if you were wondering like I was where some of the features are, the YouTube team explains it. This is a first look analysis of what we can see, and this will change and be updated. I think it's important to make this video to show how much the YouTube Studio will change. If you're watching this in the future and this is the normal YouTube Studio, how close is it to the early beta? I'm curious. However, let's dive into the new YouTube Studio. Looking at the Videos tab, we can see a list of our videos, the visibility of our videos, the upload date, the views, the comments, and the likes to dislike ratio. I think this makes a lot of sense to get all of this information at a glance in the studio area. It lets you see which videos are live, which are being monetized, and how your community is interacting with each video. Currently, you can only edit three things in the beta, and that's the title and description, the video visibility, and the video monetization settings. I want to also say, if you have access to the beta, any changes you make on the beta here will reflect on your YouTube channel, so be careful what you change. Clicking on the pencil near your video, you can edit the titles and descriptions. No tags, but as I said, not everything is here as of right now. As you can see, it has a difficult time displaying my full title, and I do hope that is something they fix. Other than that, being able to edit at a glance is very useful. Let's say I make a typo in the title and I want to quickly change it. This comes in real handy. Moving on to visibility, we have three options: public, private, and unlisted. They seemingly got rid of the scheduled videos option, and gave its functionality to private videos. When I click on it, it says schedule as public, and then it lets me choose a date and a time. I'm not gonna do this for my current video since it's already live, but it's interesting to mention, and I think it makes sense. Private was a bit confusing before, and if it takes the functionality of scheduling, I think it has more of a purpose. Finally though, is the monetization. It's very clear how to switch monetization on and off. On the old YouTube layout, it could get very confusing, so to have it as a simple yes or no is a great change. The next thing I want to cover is how to get to an individual video's analytics page. To do that, we will search at the top for a video of mine with a lot of traction. Once on the video's analytics page, you will get an overview which shows you your real-time views, your estimated revenue, your watch time, your audience retention, your views, your top search terms, which shows how people are discovering your videos, and finally, your like-to-dislike ratio for this video compared to your channel's average. I'm an analytics person and I love how easy it is to see these quickly and easily at a glance for the new studio. If I want more information, I can just click on any of the other tabs. So, for example, if I want to know how people are discovering my videos, I can click Discovery and this will show all the ways people are coming to my videos. If I want to know the audience for my videos, I can click Audience and this will show me relevant and easy to read information for all of my videos. However, if I really want to know what my audience is saying, the best way to do that is through the comments. Clicking the comments button on the left side of the studio beta brings me to my video comments page with a new change that I love. On the public comments page, it displays your most liked comments first. This makes it easy to dive into discussion on your page and see what people are talking about. To see the comments, all you need to do is click on the chat icon here, and this will display the comment chain. As you can see here, DragoNate thinks 100,000 subscribers is too high for verification, and thinks that this should be lowered. This leads to a lot of discussion here on this video. I also wanted to note that this comment is pinned on my video, but currently there is no way to see it here. It'll probably be added later, but I want to explain that if you're wondering why this one is ranking higher than another comment that has more likes. The only downside I could see to this is for large creators who get comments like, "I hate people who ask for likes, like if you agree," comment showing first, but overall I think this is a great change and will help drive discussion. Now, if you want to head back to the overview page, all you need to do is click your name near the channel like so. This will take you back to your overview videos page and back to all of your videos. You can also click the Creator Studio Beta in the top left hand corner, but that will refresh the entire studio, so keep that in mind. Overall, I think the design works and looks really good. I like the ease that I can see all of the information present, and I like the colors used to break down each individual area. I want to stress that if you ever get access to a beta, please leave feedback. Developers need it to better the product and make a better overall experience. To leave feedback, click Send Feedback and a new pop-up button will appear. I have already left my feedback before I recorded this video, and I highly encourage you to do the same on any beta you're invited to. However, let me know, what would you change right now to the YouTube Studio beta? I'm curious.
Thank you all so much for watching. Let me know, what would you like me to cover next on Andrew's Analysis? This series is a nice break between my short films and my travel vlogs, and I like to break down things in more detail. So what would you like to see next? I have a few ideas in the works, but I always like to include my audience. If you enjoyed this episode, please consider subscribing. Let me know, what was your favorite change in the new YouTube Creator Studio? I'm curious. Thank you all so much for watching, and I hope you have a great day.